but we are going through a vulgar and nature. These people made a discovery. They were sociologists or anthropologists, if you can say, that was observing scientists working in a lab in the US. And they discovered that actually writing science, you know, the idea of writing science, writing scientific paper, basically, is something extremely cultural. It is not something that is immanent, and it is the same for all scientists. No, it is something that is extremely twisted and modified by the culture, actual culture that we have. A good example is the Russian culture makes people having a lot of speculation. They describe one fact. From that fact, they are going to write 30 pages of various speculation. They will speculate, and that will give birth to many, many, many ideas and hypotheses that you could test again. So you open the door to wonders of new experiments and stuff, but one fact leads to many, many speculation in the Russian culture. At the opposite of the screen, you have the mainland Chinese way. They're accumulating facts. When we say they, it's a kind of generalization. Accumulation of facts. And when they write science, they bring you all the facts. Okay, you deal with the facts, that's the results. And they don't give you any speculation, any discussion, any implication. It goes just to, that's all the facts, and you have to, up to you to think about it. It's another culture, it's a totally different way to do it. And of course, the good way to do it doesn't exist in any culture. It's something that every student and scientist need to work and polish on the science. It's a balance between all of these. In Asia, we are closer to the Chinese side. You have noticed that many students here, they have no difficulty to write their methodology, no difficulty to write their results, and then it's about to the discussion, which is basically, what are the implications of what I'm doing? What are the speculations I can do? What are the new openings? Wow. And when it's about that part, it's where the Asian students are struggling. Will you find that? So we are, I would say, in my experience, Indonesian students or Malaysian students are closer to the Chinese culture than to the Russian culture. It's not a critique at all. It's just a statement that culture is influencing a lot our way to write science. Therefore, we need to know about that in order to be able to go beyond it. The other very important stuff that Latour and Mulgar discovered is that around science, you have two major approaches today in the 21st century. Some people believe that the facts are more important. But some other people believe that the concerns are more important. And that observation is fundamental, because it is totally pertinent to what we are living today. Whether you speak of COVID-19, whether you speak of climate change and other hot issues of today, you will find people that will say, my concern is very important, is the survival of the humankind and so on. So the facts do not prove what I am going to say, but that's not a problem because my concern is more important. Okay, so in order to address my concern, to make sure that my concern, survival of humanity, say, for example, I am able to neglect part of the facts, or even to refuse them, or even to rewrite some of them. Some other people will say, whatever the concern, I truly understand your concern, but facts are the most important stuff because this is the basement bricks on which you build. The two approaches are disputable because people dispute them. Nowadays, you see that mostly among politicians, people will tell you concerns are more important. Even some scientists, but my guess is when a scientist tells you that concerns are more important, it's already a politician scientist, someone who is doing a career, because it's political. I have a position about that. You may have your own vision. I will give you my position. My position is facts are more important. The day we start to put concerns before facts, This is today we start to do fake news. The birth of fake news is not from 20th century, it has been existing all the time. But basically, a fake news is something where you disregard the fact, you even create or you doctor your data, you are able to change your data in order to address what you think being most important, which is the concerns. So you will find that in the book Laboratory of Life by Woolgar and Latour.